Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Madam Leader. Before I begin, I would like to thank all of my family and friends who flew in from Wisconsin and from all over for being here today. In the gallery, I have my mom, Betty, my sister, Janet, my brothers, Stan and Tobin, and more cousins than I can count on a few hands. They're all over. Most important, I want to recognize my wife, Jana, and our children, Liza, Charlie, and Sam. Hey, guys. I also want to thank Speaker Boehner. For almost 5 years, he led this House. For nearly 25 years, he served it. Not many people can match his accomplishments, the offices he held, the laws he passed. But what really sets John apart is he's a man of character, a true class act. He is, without a question, the gentleman from Ohio. So please join me in saying one last time, thank you, Speaker Boehner. Now I know how he felt. It's not until you hold this gavel, stand in this spot, look out and see all 435 members of this House as if all America is sitting right in front of you. It's not till then that you feel it. The weight of responsibility, the gravity of the moment. You know, as I stand here, I can't help but think of something Harry Truman once said. The day after Franklin Roosevelt died, Truman became president, and he told a group of reporters, "If you ever pray, pray for me now." When they told me yesterday what had happened, I felt like the moon, the stars, and all the planets had fallen on me. We should all feel that way. A lot is on our shoulders. So if you ever pray, let's pray for each other. Republicans for Democrats, and Democrats for Republicans. And I don't mean pray for a conversion, all right?